So good morning students, and now in this video we shall discuss our next topic, that is the map work. Okay, and in this topic we shall discuss the map work of chapter number 1 and chapter number 2. Okay students, so please check out your map work. Please check out the first page of your textbook of the chapter number 1. And in the first page you can see that there is a map of globe, and you have to locate India, and you can very easily locate India there. The yellow colored portion of land that is known as India is located in the globe. You can easily locate there. Okay, so that map is not so much important. Please check out next map, the next one. This map is so much important, and this has the very important topics we have to discuss today. Okay, now first of all beta, we shall discuss about what is the location of standard meridian. Okay, you all know about standard meridian. Standard meridian is that imaginary line that divides India from center. Okay, this is a longitude. Standard meridian is a longitude that passes on from the complete center of India. This side and this side, it passes from the center of India, and you all know that it passes from the Mirzapur in UP. ठीक है ना, यहाँ से पास ऑन हो रहा है, एंड दैट एंड द लोकेशन, एंड द लोकेशन इज दैट इज द लॉन्गिट्यूड इज 82°30' ईस्ट. ठीक है, 82°30' ईस्ट, दैट इज द लोकेशन ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड मेरिडियन. दैट इज द लोकेशन ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड मेरिडियन इन इंडिया. द यू कैन सी हियर, दिस इज अ डॉटेड लाइन. दिस इज डॉटेड लाइन इन योर बुक्स. यू कैन इजिली सी दैट देर इज अ डॉटेड लाइन, एंड दिस डॉटेड लाइन इज द लोकेशन ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड मेरिडियन 82°30' ईस्ट. ओके जी, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक वी विल डिस्कस इन दिस वीडियो अबाउट दिस मैप. एंड बेटा नेक्स्ट टॉपिक वी आर डिस्कसिंग इन दिस वीडियो, दैट इज अगेन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, इज द लॉन्गिट्यूडनल एक्सटेंट ऑफ इंडिया. वॉट इज द लॉन्गिट्यूडनल एक्सटेंट ऑफ इंडिया? यू हैव वैन यू हैव रेड दिस चैप्टर, यू हैव डिस्कस्ड इट दैट लॉन्गिट्यूडनल एक्सटेंट ऑफ इंडिया इज बेटा 8°4' नॉर्थ. फ्रॉम 8°4' नॉर्थ, दिस इज हियर 8°4' नॉर्थ. ठीक है जी, 8°4' नॉर्थ फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट टू 37°6' नॉर्थ. फ्रॉम 8°4' नॉर्थ टू 37°6' नॉर्थ, दिस इज द लॉन्गिट्यूडनल एक्सटेंट ऑफ इंडिया. यू कैन सी हियर दैट दिस इज स्ट्रेट लाइन. This straight line is passing on from here, and at this point, this is the longitudinal extent of India, 37°6' north. Okay, similarly is the case of latitudinal extent. What is the latitudinal extent of India beta? This is from 68°7 to 97°25 east. From Kutch region in Gujarat, this is known as Sir Creek. Sir Creek region in Gujarat, it is located at 68°7 east, and the latitudinal extent of India ends at in Arunachal Pradesh, at this point, tip of Arunachal Pradesh, that is the 97°25 east. So this is the latitudinal extent of India, and the longitudinal extent of India is from Kanyakumari in Tamil Nadu to upper topmost part of Jammu and Kashmir, that is from 8°4 north to 37°6 north. Longitudes, ठीक है, दिस इज longitudes एंड दिस इज latitudes. ओके बेटा, सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मैप, एंड इन दिस मैप वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट स्टैंडर्ड मेरिडियन, द लोकेशन ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड मेरिडियन, द latitudinal extent ऑफ इंडिया, एंड द longitudinal extent ऑफ इंडिया. ओके, नेक्स्ट इन द नेक्स्ट मैप ऑफ दिस चैप्टर यू कैन सी दैट इंडिया इज वेरी प्रॉपरली connected with the other nations of the world through seas. Okay, and that's why India does its most of the trade from this sea route. You can see that there are three sides of India is covered from seas. Here is Arabian Sea, this side Arabian Sea, below Indian Ocean, this is Indian Ocean, and this side Bay of Bengal. So from three sides India is covered by seas: Arabian Sea, Indian Ocean, Bay of Bengal, and that is the reason that in most of the India, 90% of India's trade is done through these sea regions, ocean regions. So you can see that in the map, India is very easily and properly connected by seas through most parts of the world, and most of the trade of India is done through the seas, because there are three sides India is covered by seas: Bay of Bengal, Indian Ocean, Arabian Sea. In the next map of this chapter, you can see that the location of India, that the political map, of India, and the 28 and now the 28 states of India. This one, the map in the map given in your book is the older map. At present, there are 28 states. Okay, not 29 states. At present, there are 28 states in India, and 9 union territories. 28 states and 8 union territories. Sorry. Dadar and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu have been merged. So 28 states and 8 union territories. Why 28 states? Because Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh have become union territories. Okay, so that's why India has 8 union territories and 28 states. The map given in your textbook is an older map. Okay, beta. So this was the description about the map work of chapter number 1. Now we shall discuss about the maps of chapter number 2. Okay, so I'm rubbing this now, and you can see that this map is almost covered. Okay, we shall now come to the second map. So I'm rubbing this now. Okay, now beta, this is chapter number 2. I have drawn the map here. Okay, this is chapter number 2's map. First of all, in chapter number 2, we shall discuss about the Himalayan ranges. Dekho beta, these are the Himalayan ranges. You all know there are 6 type of physical features of India. The first physical feature of India is the Himalayas. These are the Himalayas. From Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, then Nepal, Sikkim, Bhutan, and Arunachal Pradesh. This whole region is the Himalayan range. And when we talk about Himalayan range, there are 3 types. First one is the Great Himalayas or Inner Himalayas. In this, we see that there are 2 types of ranges, Karakoram range and Jhanskar range. These Karakoram range and Jhanskar range are the part of these Great Himalayas or the Himadri range. Okay, next, number 2, there is the Himachal range or Lesser Himalayas. These are the Himachal ranges or Lesser Himalayas. These Himalayas are not so much high. These are not so much high, and that's why the ranges like Pir Panjal range, etc., falls in this category. Here is Pir Panjal range. These are not so much high. These are known as Himachal or Lesser Himalayas. Next, number 3, these are Shivalik ranges. The Shivalik ranges are those ranges that borders the Punjab region. पंजाब के और हिमाचल के बिल्कुल बॉर्डर पर जो आपकी वो शुरू होती है हिमालयन रेंजेस, दीज आर नोन एज शिवालिक रेंजेस. ओके, सो दिस वाज द फर्स्ट फिजिकल फीचर ऑफ इंडिया, दैट इज द हिमालयस. इंडिया हैज सिक्स फिजिकल फीचर्स. फर्स्ट वन इज द हिमालयस या द ग्रेट हिमालयस. ठीक है, द हिमालयस एंड हिमालयस आर टू 3 टाइप्स, फर्स्ट टाइप, सेकेंड टाइप, थर्ड टाइप. नेक्स्ट, नंबर टू बेटा इज द नॉर्दर्न प्लेट्स. यू कैन सी हियर द नॉर्दर्न प्लेट्स. नाउ दीज नॉर्दर्न प्लेन्स बेटा बिगिंस फ्रॉम पंजाब रीजन. वैसे ये कहना गलत होगा कि दिस बिगिन फ्रॉम दिस पंजाब. एक्चुअली दिस नॉर्दर्न प्लेन्स बिगिन फ्रॉम द पाकिस्तानी पंजाब, फ्रॉम दिस साइड. बट दिस पार्ट ऑफ पाकिस्तान वेंट टू द साइड ऑफ पाकिस्तान, एंड दैट इज वाई दिस इज नॉट द पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया. सो वी काउंट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ नॉर्दर्न प्लेन्स फ्रॉम दिस साइड, फ्रॉम इंडियन पंजाब, फ्रॉम पंजाब, हरियाणा, उत्तर प्रदेश, बिहार एंड वेस्ट बंगाल. These are the regions of Northern Plains. Also, even Bangladesh is also the part of Northern Plains, but this again is a separate country. So that's why we don't count Northern Plains here. So in India, when we count about Northern Plains in India, it begins from Punjab, Indian region of Punjab, Haryana, next Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and West Bengal. Okay, and parts of Tripura are also the parts of Northern Plains, some parts of Tripura. Okay, so this is our Northern Plains. Next, number three beta is the plateau region. This is the plateau region of India, and plateau region again has 3 types. First type is the Malwa Plateau. First part is the Malwa Plateau. द मालवा प्लेट. ओके, नेक्स्ट नंबर टू. नंबर टू हियर ऑन राइट साइड छोटा नागपुर प्लेटी, छोटा नागपुर प्लेटी. एंड नंबर थ्री, नंबर थ्री इज द मोस्ट, इज द लार्जेस्ट वन, इज द लार्जेस्ट वन ऑफ द प्लेट्यूज, दैट इज योर डेक्कन प्लेटी, दैट इज योर डेक्कन प्लेटी. सो दीज आर द थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ प्लेट्यू रीजन्स ऑफ इंडिया. फर्स्ट वन इज मालवा मालवा प्लेट्यू, सेकेंड छोटा नागपुर प्लेट्यू, नेक्स्ट द डेक्कन प्लेटी. ठीक है बेटा, दीज आर द थ्री फिजिकल फीचर्स ऑफ इंडिया वी हैव डिस्कस. फर्स्ट इज द हिमालयस विच हैज थ्री पार्ट्स, सेकेंड वन इज द नॉर्दर्न प्लेन्स विच बिगिन्स फ्रॉम पंजाब टू वेस्ट बंगाल. ओके, दीज आर हिमालयस, दीज आर नॉर्दर्न प्लेन्स. एंड थर्ड रीजन वी हैव डिस्कस इज द प्लेट्यूज, द प्लेट्यूज. दिस इज द रीजन ऑफ प्लेट्यूज फ्रॉम एरावलीज टू द सदर्न पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया. ओके, बिगिनिंग फ्रॉम एरावलीज देन दिस विंध्या एंड दिस पार्ट, होल पार्ट, दिस होल पार्ट इज द डेक्कन प्लेट्यू, दिस होल रीजन. एंड इट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू थ्री पार्ट्स, द मालवा प्लेट्यू, दिस रीजन मालवा प्लेट्यू, दिस रीजन इज छोटा नागपुर प्लेट्यू, एंड द होल बिलो रीजन इज नोन एज डेक्कन प्लेट्यू. ओके, दीज आर द थ्री फिजिकल फीचर्स ऑफ इंडिया. नेक्स्ट नंबर फोर, द फोर्थ फिजिकल फीचर ऑफ इंडिया इज बेटा कोस्टल प्लेन्स, कोस्टल प्लेन्स. दीज आर द कोस्टल प्लेन्स बेटा, दीज पार्ट्स, दिस पार्ट, दिस इज नोन एज वेस्टर्न कोस्टल प्लेन. दिस पार्ट, दिस स्मॉलर पार्ट, दिस स्मॉल पैच ऑफ लैंड, दिस स्मॉल पैच ऑफ लैंड इज नोन एज वेस्टर्न कोस्टल प्लेन. हाउ वेस्टर्न कोस्टल, वट इज द लोकेशन ऑफ वेस्टर्न कोस्टल प्लेन? It begins from the coastal line of India, from Arabian Sea. Begins from the coastal line of India from Arabian Sea and goes up to the Western Ghats. These are Western Ghats. So these Western Ghats act as a border line for the Western Coastal Plains and the seashore. So between this, the small patch of land is known as Western Coastal Plains. Okay. Similar is the case of Eastern Coastal Plains. This is known as Eastern Coastal Plains. This Eastern Coastal Plains. It begins from the eastern coastal side of India, from Bay of Bengal, eastern coastal side of India, and goes up to the Eastern Ghats. So this is between this land is known as Eastern Coastal Plains. Eastern Coastal Plains are wider as compared to the Western Coastal Plains. Okay, so that means Eastern Coastal Plains are two types: Western Coastal Plains and Eastern Coastal Plains. Okay, next number five, your Ghats. The Ghats, that means it again has two parts: Western Ghats and number two Eastern Ghats. ठीक है ना, तो ये आपको बताई दिया मैंने. This part of land, these are the hilly regions. So this part of land is known as which acts as a border line between the sea and the Western Coastal Plains. This part is known as the Western Ghats, and Western Ghats have small passes through it, and it is almost continuous land, continuous part, but small, it has small passes. Okay, so that's our Western Ghats. The Eastern Ghats have very large gaps in between. Here is a large gap, here is a large gap. Okay, it is not a continuous one. So these Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats act as a borderline between the seashore and the Western Coastal Plains and Eastern Coastal Plains. Okay, next, last part is number six, the Thar Desert, which is also known as the Great Indian Desert. The Thar Desert. Okay, this Thar Desert is in the Rajasthan region, and we also call it the Great Indian Desert. And this Thar Desert is the part of the Rajasthan state of India. Especially the western part of Rajasthan is the almost whole is a sandy region, and this is Thar Desert. Okay, so these are the six physical features of India. The first physical feature is the Himalayas, which has three types. Okay, next, second physical feature is the Northern Plains, which begins from Punjab to West Bengal region of India. Next, the Plateau regions, which begins from Aravalis to the southern part of India. It again has three types: the Malwa Plateau, the Chota Nagpur Plateau, and the Deccan Plateau. Next, the Coastal Plains, Western Coastal Plains, Eastern Coastal Plains. Okay, and next, the Ghats, Western Ghats, Eastern Ghats. And the last part is the Great Indian Desert, that is the Thar Desert, which is in Rajasthan. So this is the beta, this is the map work. This is the map work of India, which we have read today. That is the 6 physical features of India. Okay. So this was your today's topic about map work of chapter number 1 and chapter number 2. And please study your map work and do it in your atlas. Okay. Still you have any doubts, you can send me your doubts in the query section, in the comment section of this video. Okay. So this was our today's video, beta. Thank you so much. And I hope you have learned something. Still you have any doubts, now you can send me your doubts in the query section of the comments. Okay, in the comment section. So please send your doubts if you have. And so thank you so much, students. Thank you, and God bless you all. Thank you.